this video, I will give you an introduction to the theme Urban Services and Infrastructures. And I will shortly address how this challenge is related to general notions of fundamental needs and sustainability. In the end, the main goal of any development is to achieve a prosperous society. But what does it mean? This is hard to answer, as it will be differently for all of us, depending on the different living conditions in our world. The definition of prosperity now depends on needs of future generations. UN Habitat introduced some years ago the City Prosperity Index. The ranking of cities regarding prosperity is based on 5 indicators or dimensions, which are productivity, infrastructure development, quality of life, equity and social inclusion, and environmental sustainability. In a way, these 5 dimensions relate strongly to the main perspectives or focuses to achieve sustainable development, often referred to as triple P, people, planet, profit, where the notion of profit was changed in the 2002 Johannesburg Treaty into prosperity. Within this triple P approach, the different 24 aspects to address sustainability in our living environment are framed. In this frame, the planet aspects relate to the technical aspects, or so-called stocks and flows, in the local environment, like energy, space, water, and waste. The people aspects, as shown here, are related to livability, like air or soil contamination, safety and quality-related aspects, such as available green and social inclusion. Finally, the profit-related aspects concern economic vitality and future values, such as local employment, flexibility and robustness. Together, they address what we could frame the urban services, which often are related to infrastructure development. And this aspect was highlighted, as you saw before, within the City Prosperity Index of UN Habitat, as a separate indicator of prosperity. Why? This is related to our dependence on areas around cities, dependence to resources, to other places and cities, and the availability of often cheap transport. This has led to what some call the interconnected society, where urbanized area consists of different urban nodes, which are highly interconnected. This is also called polycentric urban development, like shown here, for example, to the northwestern part of Europe, for the area between London, Paris, Berlin and Amsterdam. Triple P, and in particular the notion of prosperity, forms the basis of sustainable development. This notion was introduced in the Brundtland report in 1987. In simple words, this means that our children need to inherit an equal or better world than we have ourselves. So sustainable development is not a static notion. It also relates strongly to how we try to achieve sustainability and how to respond to environmental pressure and aspects of change, such as climate change. Here, 2 actions are distinguished: tackling causes, or doing things the right way, called mitigation, and handling impacts, or responding to negative aspects, called adaptation. The International Panel for Climate Change calculated the potential for different sectors to mitigate, and by doing so, where most potential to achieve carbon reductions are. As you can see in the graph, in particular buildings, transport and energy supply are key sectors to achieve positive change towards a sustainable society. Often, such change, be it mitigation or adaptation, is related to trying to achieve to change the way we organize our society. From one based in linear flows of input and output, into one which is based on circular flows, where output can become input again, often referred to as renewables. And this is strongly related to this video's theme of urban services and infrastructures. Infra is Latin and refers to below. Infrastructures are defined as the essential or fundamental facilities and systems serving a country, city or area, including the services and facilities necessary of its economy to function. Of course, it doesn't refer only to structures below the ground. Infrastructures are all over to provide our society with essential services such as transportation of people, goods, energy and water. The importance of infrastructure for our society has increased significantly. As UN Habitat already implied by including infrastructure as a main indicator of prosperity. At the moment, infrastructure often drives urban development, which is referred to as the existing paradigm, as originally this was the other way around, namely that urban development defined infrastructures. For this reason, I will take you one step back to the need for infrastructure. So what defines the need for infrastructure? This is called the suprastructure and defined as the different standards of societal needs and goals. To define the need for infrastructure, we should look at the relation between infrastructures, buildings and systems with the societal goals that are aimed at. There are so-called fundamental needs to support societal goals. These fundamental needs are the same for every human on Earth. They are support, like for instance provision of food, etc. Protection, like a roof above the head. And further, affection, understanding, participation, relaxation, expression and freedom. Cities are physical expressions of social structures and the fulfillment of these fundamental needs. Activities to sustain fundamental needs can be called urban services. Examples are transportation of material flows, supply of water, supply of energy, etc. But also housing or cultivation and provision of food. Such urban services can be materialized. This is what we know as transportation infrastructure, public utilities like sewerage, ICT, and so forth. But this also concerns urban ordering and planning and land development.